السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته dear students. I'm PSE physics. Today we are going to solve the 2024 paper 4 exam for February March. This is the exam. This is physics 0625 paper 4 February March 2024. This is the first question. In figure is a speed time graph for the first 5 minutes for a bus journey. Describe the motion between t equals 0.9 minutes and t equals 2.9 minutes. So he's asking about the description of the motion between these two times. That's that part. This is a horizontal part in the speed time graph, so it's constant speed. Constant speed between t equals 2.9 and t equals 3.5. 2.9 and 3.5, this part is going down, straight line downwards, so this is the speed is decreasing regularly, so this is regular deceleration or uniform deceleration. Between time equals 3.5 and 4.5 minutes, from 3.5 to 4.5 minutes the speed was zero, so the object was at rest. Another bus travels at a speed of 8.9 meter per second. The brakes apply a constant force and the bus stops in 23 meters. This bus has a mass of 18,000 kilograms. Calculate the kinetic energy of the bus before the brakes are applied. Kinetic energy equals half mv squared, that's half times 18,000 times v squared, which 8.9 squared, that's on the calculator, you can get it 712890 joules. Calculate the force applied to stop the bus. We don't have time to calculate the acceleration, but we have energy used, which is equals to work. And we have distance equal to 23, so we can calculate the work equals the energy lost, which is 712890 equals force times distance. This is the work, that's force times 23, so the force equals 712890 divided 23, so that's about 31 kilonewton. It's 30995.2 newton. Define impulse. Impulse is force times time of its action. That's impulse equal F times T. The figure shows a rocket and its exhaust gas. The exhaust gas are emitted from the rocket with a velocity of 1400 meters per second and at a rate of 2800 kilogram per second. Show that the force exerted on the rocket by the exhaust gas is 3900 kilonewton. State the equation used. Every second, we will look at every second. Every second. Every second. So I'm taking time equal 1 second. I have 2800 kilograms of exhaust gas were at rest, and then they will be accelerated to 1400 meter per second from rest. So their acceleration is 1400 minus 0 divided 1 second. So it's, this is the acceleration, and this is the mass. Of course, the force equals mass times acceleration. That's mass times divided 1. That's 2800, which is the mass per second, times 1400, which give us, which will give us this number as 3920 kilonewton, which is approximate to the given value of 3900 kilonewton. Calculate the maximum mass that this force can lift from the ground, ignoring air resistance. Of course, the maximum mass, the force equals weight, which is equals to mass times g. So 3920000 equals the unknown mass times 9.8, which is the g. So the mass equals 400,000 kilograms. So the maximum mass is 400,000 kilograms. This is the third question. A car has a weight of 13,000 newtons. The car is supported by 4 tires. The area of each tire is 0.016 meter square. That's in contact with the road. Calculate the pressure of the weight of the car on the road. The pressure equals force divided total area. That's 13,000 divided 4 times 0.016. The pressure equals 203,125 pascals. So that's 203,125 pascals. Explain in terms of particles why this air pressure in the tire increases when the car travels along the roads. As the car travels, friction of tires with road cause the tires to become hotter, so air molecules inside tires move faster, colliding with the tire more forcefully and frequently. So they are more strongly and more frequently colliding with the tires, exerting more force and hence more pressure. That's why the pressure, so pressure increase. A gas cylinder contains helium gas at pressure of 2 times 10 power 6 pascal, a volume of 0.026 meter cubic of the compressed gas is released from the cylinder into balloons. Each balloon contains 0.015 meter cubic of helium at an atmospheric pressure of 1 times 10 power 5 pascal. temperature remains constant, calculate the maximum number of the balloons that can be filled. I will use the gas law for the pressure and volume, which is P1, V1 equals P2, V2. P1 here is 2 times 10 power 6 Pascal, and V1 is given as 0.026, which must equal to 1 times 10 power 5 Pascals times V2, which is the number of balloons times the volume of each balloon, which is 0.015. So the number of balloons equal 2 times 10 power 6 times divided to this give us 34.67 balloons. Of course, we can't have 0.67 balloons, and we can't inflate the 35th balloon completely. So the only number of balloons that can be filled, or the maximum number of balloons that can be filled, is 34 balloons only. Because the 35th balloon will not be totally inflated. Define specific heat capacity. This is the amount of thermal energy needed to increase temperature of 1 kilogram of matter by 1 degree Celsius. A volume of 0.0024 meter cubic of oil is heated in pan for 7 minutes. Temperature of the oil is increased from 20 to 180 degrees Celsius. Density of oil is 910 kilogram per meter cubic, with a specific heat capacity of 2000 joules per kilogram degrees Celsius. Calculate the mass of the oil. Mass equals density times volume. That's density, which is 910, times volume, which is 0.0024. That's 2.18 kilograms. So the mass is 2.18 kilograms. Calculate the energy required to increase the temperature of the oil. We have the formula of amount of heat, which is equal to mc delta t. So that's equal to 2.18 times c, which is 2000 joules per kilogram degrees Celsius. That's 2000 times delta t, which is 180 minus 20. That's 698880 joules. Calculate the power required to supply the energy calculated. Power equals energy divided time. So the energy is 698880 joules divided the time, which is 7 minutes. Of course, we don't use minutes, we use the seconds. So that's 7 times 60. So the power is 1664 watts. Next question. The table shows applications of regions of the electromagnetic spectrum. Complete second column of the table with regions of the electromagnetic spectrum used for each application. Choose from the list. Each region may be used once, more than once, or not at all. Bluetooth uses radio waves. The optical fibers, they use infrared. Security marking, ultra violet. Sterilizing foods, gamma rays. Wireless internet, microwaves. State the approximate speed of the radio waves in air. 3 times 10 power 8 meters per second. The figure shows successive crests of a wave after a plane wave has passed through a gap. Draw 3 successive crests before the wave reach the gap. So we have to draw 3 wave crests before the gap. What's important here is that before reaching the gap, the waves are straight, and this length is the wavelength. So I need this length to judge where the wave crests are going to be. So one crest will be here, and the other I can take this same distance and repeat it. So the next one is here, and the third one is here. This is the answer for the required 3 successive crests before the gap. The figure shows a much wider gap. A plane wave of the same wavelength as in before is incident on this gap, which is wider from the left side of the barrier. Draw 3 successive crests of the wave after the waves have passed through the gap. So now I have a wider gap. This is a wider gap, and the 3 successive crests are incident on it. We need to draw the wave after it passed through the gap, which is now wider. We know that the diffraction will be less, so it will be somehow curved this and that sides, and in between it will be more or less straight. And we take the same distance as the wavelengths from here. So let's start maybe from this point, and second curve on this side and that side, and another one, same distance, and a curve here and a curve on this side, and more or less straight in between. And be careful that this distance is the wavelength, which is equal to that, equal to that, equal to that. These are all wavelengths. The figure shows a full-scale diagram of an object O and its image I produced by a converging lens. The lens and its position on the principal axis are not shown. On the figure, draw a single ray to locate the position of the center of the converging lens and a line to represent the position of the lens labeled L. So I need to find the position of the lens center and to represent the lens itself. To find the position of the lens center, I need to draw one ray from the top of the object to the top of its inverted image. It crosses the principal axis at the center, so here is the center of the lens. This is the position of the center of the lens, and I can draw the lens itself like this. The lens is exactly here. Next, he wants to determine the focal length by drawing another ray. So I will draw another ray which is parallel to the principal axis, so it will be refracted to pass through the focus of the lens. It starts at the tip of the object, so it refracts to pass at the tip of the image, which is inverted, of course. So here is the focus of the lens. This is the focus, and he needs to find out the focal length. This is the focal length. Focal length is the distance CF, which by measuring it will be 2.1 centimeter. Of course, you need to measure it on the hard copy of the exam, which is printed to scale, so you will find it about 2.1 centimeters. So the focal length is 2.1, as we said, by measuring. Object is moved 2 centimeters closer to the lens, stays the 2 changes to the characteristic of the image. Now the object is moved 2 centimeters closer to the lens. We say this distance is 2 centimeters, so the other focus is right here. So if you move 2 centimeters closer, so the object will be here, so it's nearer to the lens than the focus. So this object will be moved to this position. It's now closer than the focus. I will draw one ray starting from the tip, passing through the center of the lens, and it will not be refracted. This is one ray. Another ray is to be drawn parallel to the principal axis, which will be refracted to pass through the focus of the lens, which is here. You can see that the 2 rays will not intersect. If I extend them, they will meet somewhere here, and so the image will be somewhere here. You can see that the image is upright now, it's not inverted as it was, and it's virtual. It is virtual because it's formed by the intersection of the extension of the refracted rays, not the rays themselves. So the 2 changes that occur, that it's now upright and it's virtual. Next, draw the circuit symbol for potential dividers. The potential divider is drawn like this, same like the variable resistor. You can draw it horizontal or vertical, both are correct. This is a circuit. Calculate the value V out when the value R is 3 kilo ohm. So this is 3 kilo ohm. He needs to find the V out. Of course, the 6 volts will be divided among the 1 and 3. So it's divided into 1, 2, 3. So 6 to be divided to 1, 2, 3. So it will be divided into 1.5 to 4.5. Here is 4.5 volts and here is 1.5 volts. If you want to calculate it by a formula, you need to find the equivalent resistance, which is 1 plus 3, that's 4 kilo ohm. So the current is 6 divided 4000 ampere. So the voltage here is V equals I times R, that's 6 divided 4000 times 1000, which is 1 kilo ohm. That's 6 divided 4000 times 1000, which is 1 kilo ohm. That's 6 divided 4, which is 1.5 volts the same. So the V out is 1.5 volts. The value R is adjusted until the current is 1.7 milliampere. Calculate the charge that flows through the circuit in 300 seconds. Amount of charge equals I times T. So it equals 1.7 times 10 power negative 3 times 300, which will give us 0.51 coulombs. The figure shows a wire carrying a large current passing through a square card. The square card is viewed from above. Draw 3 magnetic field lines that indicate the direction of the magnetic field and show how the strength varies with distance from the wire. Of course, the X indicates that it's inward or into the beige. So using the right hand grip rule, this is my right hand, This is my thumb. And here is the four fingers. They are rotating in the direction of the field, and the finger is aiming to the direction inward. So I'll find out that the four fingers, if this is inward, the four fingers are clockwise. So I need to draw three circles. First circle will be close to the wire. Second is a little bit further. Third is more and more further to indicate that the field strength is decreasing as you go further away from the wire. Of course, the direction is, as we said, from the right hand grip rule is clockwise. The current in the wire is increased and the direction of the current is reversed. State how these changes affect the magnetic field. Of course, the magnetic field becomes stronger and direction is reversed. So it will be anti-clockwise. Electricity is transmitted at high voltage. Explain why high voltage increases the efficiency of transmission even with thinner wire. The electric power loss in wire equals I squared R. So if voltage is increased, current will decrease such that VI will be constant. As current I decreases, the power loss I squared R is much decreased, and hence transmission efficiency is increased. An experiment directs alpha particles at a very thin sheet of gold foil. Most of the alpha particles pass through the thin foil in a straight line. State a conclusion about the atoms from this observation. Atoms are very small and most of its volume is space. Some of the alpha particles are deflected through angles less than 90 degrees and few deflected through 180 degrees. State and explain two conclusions about the nuclei of the atom from this observation. Nuclei are very small compared to the size of the atom. Compared to size of atom. Explanation: because few alpha particles only were deflected. Conclusion 2, the nuclei are positively charged. Explanation: because they repelled the alpha particles, causing their deflection even backward. A source contains a radioactive isotope of strontium. This isotope decays by beta particles emission. The half-life is 29 years. Stages change in the nucleus, which occurs when the beta particles are emitted. Neutron that's of 0, 1, 0 charge and 1 mass is changed into a beta particle, which is negative 1 charge and 0 mass, plus proton, which is 1, 1. So 1 neutron is changed into a proton and beta particle. The initial mass of the isotope strontium is 25 micrograms. Calculate the mass of strontium isotope that decays in 87 days. 87 days divided 29, that's 3 half-lives. So the 25 micrograms after 1 half-life become 12.5, after another half-life become 6.25, after a third half-life becomes 3 micrograms. So what decays, he want to know what decays in 87, what decays is 25 minus 3.125, that's 21.875 micrograms decaying. So the decay are 21.875 micrograms, which will decay in 87 years. Figure represents different positions of the moon as it rotates around the Earth. State the position of the moon where an observer on Earth sees there is quarter moon, A and E. A and E. Here he will see quarter moon, and here he will see a quarter moon too. Full moon, the only position is this one. This is a full moon, which is G. State the approximate time taken for the moon to orbit Earth, 27.5 days. The average distance of Earth from Sun is 1.5 times 10 power 8 kilometers. Calculate the average orbital speed of the Earth in kilometer per hour. Average speed is the circumference of the orbit of Earth around the Sun divided the time it takes. Of course, the time it takes is in hours is 365 days times 24 hours. The circumference is 2 pi times the radius in kilometers, which is 1.5 times 10 power 8 kilometers. That's 1.07 times 10 power 5 kilometers per hour. The speed of light in vacuum is 3 times 10 power 8 meter per second. Calculate the time taken for the light from the Sun to reach Earth. Time equals distance divided speed. The distance is the radius of the orbit of Earth around the Sun, which is 1.5 times 10 power 8. 1.5 times 10 power 8 in kilometers times 10 power 3 to be in meters divided 3 times 10 power 8, that's 500 seconds. So it's 500 seconds. State the condition required for a protostar to become a stable star. The force of gravitational pull inwards must equal the thermal radiation force outwards. Define the Hubble constant. Hubble constant is the ratio between speed of galaxies moving away from Earth divided their distance from Earth. Hubble constant equals V divided D. Current estimate for the Hubble constant is 2.2 times 10 power negative 18 per second. Still, the equation which gave the an estimate for the age of the universe. Age of the universe equal 1 over Hubble constant. Calculate an estimate for the age of the universe. So it's 1 divided 2.2 times 10 power negative 18. That's 10 power 18 divided 2.2, which is 4.55 times 10 power 17 seconds. We already finished the exam. I hope everything is clear for you. I'm waiting for any questions from you. Thank you very much and wish you all best of luck. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.